Hello guys, we meet again with Ang Bob. Another video about looting pond. Okay, today we have a swimming pond. Let me 68. Let's check it out. Okay, now we go to settings about pond, and we can see that this pond is based on Android 9 and Mi 11. Okay. First thing to do is activate the developer option. So we click the Mi version 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Since I've already done it, okay. Then we go hit the back button once and go to the additional settings. Okay. And go to the developer option. Turn off the OEM unlock and on the USB debugging, okay. But before, you have to insert the Mi account in here, okay. I think you should already know how to do it. You can check in my other video, okay. After you insert the Mi account, you go to the additional settings, the proper option, okay. Hit the Mi unlock status and add account. Okay, if you see there is a note after you click this add account, we should see a message that like this: added successfully. Okay, so if added successfully, we can unlock it from the password. Okay, and before, one more thing, you have to erase all the email. Okay, just to make sure you don't lock with your email or FRP. Okay, so we put down this pawn in here and open the command prompt. Okay, then we type add space reboot space bootloader and hit the enter button. Okay, the pawn will boot into the fastboot mode like this. Okay, and then we open the Mi unlock. Okay, you can download it from the Xiaomi website. Okay, you just need to put the phone number plus 62 if you are in Indonesia, the code, country code. If you are in another country, you can insert your own code, and after that insert your phone number and the password. Enter and you will welcome the apps with this message. Okay, for that we just need to click the unlock this, wait for 5 seconds, hit the unlock again and wait another 5 seconds. This is to be noted that unlock bootloader will erase your internal storage, so make sure you have to backup the storage. Okay, click unlock anyway. Okay, after unlock, it usually erase the internal storage and go booting to the Android, but I don't want to go to the Android, so I just want to flash this one to unboot it. Okay, just for noted that Android 9 sometimes will make your device break, so for safety we are going to downgrade the firmware into Android. We will force the phone go to the fastboot mode by push the volume down and power button. Okay, we want to try safety, so we want to downgrade it. Okay, as you can see in here, I already have a Android 8 firmware. Okay, you can check the link download on the link description. I will write in it there. Okay, you just need to click this one and right click on the blank space, hit the shift button and right click open PowerShell. Okay, we'll minimize this one and we just need to type flash and hit tab button for auto complete and press enter. Okay, this is isn't necessary to downgrade the firmware, but just to be safety. Okay, sometimes if you're a newbie and rooting Android Xiaomi Redmi 6A, it will be a problem. So I just will give you the safe way. Okay. Wait. Okay. After we downgrade this firmware, we can directly root this device. But I also want to custom this phone. Okay. Custom is not based on OSP, but based on also MIUI that already deodex and debloated. Okay, so it will much faster, and there is no bloatware. Sorry for my bad English, this is not my first language, so bear with me. File is divided into 16 spares, so installer, I don't know, but just make the flashing more faster, I think. Okay, after the flashing from the Facebook is completed, I don't want to go to the Android, so I just want to directly request the custom recovery or the TWRP. So we will force the phone go to the export mode again. Okay, it's now completed. I will force the phone into the desktop again by pressing the volume down and the power button. Okay, I will open the folder that contain the custom recovery. So I will open this command prompt here. Okay, now I will type password space flash space recovery space, and I want to use this one. Okay. And after that we'll minimize this one and type Facebook space reboot, but before I'm pressing the enter button, okay, make sure to, after we press the enter button, we must press the volume up. Okay, enter button, press volume up. Okay, still holding down the volume up button. Okay. see there is a welcome message, but still in Chinese language, so we will change the language. Let's click in here and click this one and click this one to English. Okay, and hit this one. Okay, now we're in the English language. So I want to wipe the internet storage, so we select the wipe menu, format data, type yes, and click the enter button. Okay, now hit the home button, select the reboot, and select cargo again. Okay, just to be noted, I want to press the Geodex ROM after this one. Okay, so we select the wipe again, and this time we select the advanced wipe. Select 3, checklist, graphic, data and cache, and select the button. Okay, now put down the phone, and we open the explorer again. As you can see, the internal storage is not related by the internal memory. Internal phone storage is not related by the Windows, so we need to install it using the LDB setload. Okay, so I select the advanced LDB setload and just swipe in here. Okay, you can see it's already connected, and we open the file explorer. Okay, I want to create a comment. So I type adb space setload and click and drag the Geodex. Okay, and hit enter. I will wait for another minute. You can see there is progress in here. Ready. migration. Okay, you can see that this Deodexrom is based on NIV 10.3.3. I think it's the most stable. But you can freely choose another custom ROM. Okay. Please just make sure that you have downgrade to Android 8.1 or Oreo. Because sometimes Android 9 or Pi is making your device break. And as we know that it will need an out account, okay, so it will be a problem, so just make sure you don't get the Android version. Space, go to the pawn, go to the advanced, select enemy sandbox and swipe it. Okay, and open this file manager and find the zip in this file. Okay, I want to select this magis 21.2, so I will click and drag in here and press enter. Okay. See, there's a progress in here. Okay, and now done. We still need to hit the reboot system. Okay, and we'll wait for another couple of minutes. that home screen. Let's see. It's a welcome screen. We just have to select next. That's why I will change the language into English. Need to insert the new compressor that we created before. Okay. You can set the Wi-Fi. Okay. Wi-Fi. Set the Wi-Fi. Okay. Set this new. Okay, I don't want to sync the Mi Clock. And so we'll put in. this kind of gate. You can see this already means manager here. I'm going to disable the automatic update regulator. Okay, now we want to disable the protect just for sure. Okay, and I want to use this manage manager because I want to install the manage manager manually. Okay. Now we go to the settings. The phone, okay, you can check in here that our Redmi 6A is already downgraded to Android 8 or Oreo and using new 10.3 and 0.3 stable. Okay, we want to enable the USB debugging, so go to the new version, click it 5 times. 5, okay, back. I will enable the notification. And I want to set the sleep to 10 minutes, okay. So, additional settings, network option, and enable the USB block. Okay. Just click OK in here. And change the USB charging into the transfer file, okay. Put the point in here. To the laptop and copy some file. Okay, I want copy this the Magis Manager. Okay, 0.4 and paste it in here. And I want to copy the root checker. Okay, root checker and here. Right click, copy and paste it. Okay. You can see there is already two APK file in here. So we go back to the phone and open the file in there. Okay, let's click accept. Now, and we can see the file that we copied before. Let's click the images. We ask for permission, okay, describe settings and never allow from the source. Okay, now we're back. Install the root checker. Okay, we're done. Now opening the image manager. Okay, as usual, if you ask for permission, just click OK. And now it will download this manager. It will download the zip images. Okay, after that, it will reboot. After 5 seconds. Okay. Screen. Let's check it out. Okay, can you use media? Usually for the first time we open the image manager, it will force close, but it seems it doesn't force close. Okay, you can see this, it's already installed. the checkout instruction. Okay, just click check and it will ask for permission. Okay, just granted. And here we go. Already have PowerPoint loaded. Okay, thank you very much. To this, you can repack your Magisk Manager. Add the apps that you want to, so it will not read by the root and etc. Okay, thank you. I hope this tutorial is helpful for you. If you like it, I'm very appreciated if you click the like and subscribe button. If I need it, I will include it in the description box. Okay, thank you very much, everyone. Have a nice day. Assalamualaikum.